Taoiseach, you said earlier on that I think the words you used were unhelpful or uncomfortable. Some of the language that's been used by presidential candidates in terms of immigrants in the United States during the election campaign. Could I just ask you whether we don't need to just be a little bit more forthright in roundly condemning the language of one particular candidate, Mr. Donald Trump, who has been condemned by governments, by civil rights organizations and human rights organizations for using what can only be described as despicable language, utterly despicable and racist language. He accused Mexico of exporting its rapists, I'm quoting him, its rapists and criminals to the United States. He has, and this is very relevant to the undocumented Irish, he has called for the expulsion of all 11.3 million undocumented workers in the United States. Now, Taoiseach, this is the same Donald Trump that Minister Michael Noonan met in Shannon Airport in May of 2014 with a red carpet and harps and people dressed in traditional Irish dress in what was frankly even at the time a quite ludicrous show of deference to this multi-billionaire. But this same person now turns out to be somebody who is literally whipping up an outrageous and dangerous, Taoiseach, dangerous hysteria against the undocumented, which include the Irish undocumented. Now, I just really ask myself, one, do we regret rolling out the red carpet for a man who would say this about immigrants in the United States? And are we going to condemn what he is saying? Because he will hear those words, given his investment in this country. It will be something he will hear if the Irish Taoiseach, the Irish political system, condemn him utterly for the words that he's used to describe immigrants, wherever they may be from, undocumented immigrants in the United States. So I would ask you to respond to that, and indeed to make that forthright condemnation. Because when somebody is being racist, and that's what he's being, and whipping up dangerous hysteria, where there's serious reports of immigrants actually suffering heightened levels of violence and threats and racist stereotyping, because specifically because of the language and rhetoric that Donald Trump has used. It is emboldening the worst and most racist elements in the United States to attack, target, vilify, demonize, and physically attack, in some cases, undocumented immigrants. Mostly directed at Mexicans, but he said he wants to expel all undocumented workers from the United States. Can I also ask Taoiseach whether, in the context of the refugee crisis, and particularly the situation in Syria, and how that has been one of the major centres from which these refugees are fleeing. Did you, as we asked you to back earlier this year on a number of occasions, did you raise criticism, questions, concerns about the United States' own role in creating the conditions for this refugee crisis? Through their actions in Iraq, through their support for Saudi Arabia, through their arming of these regimes who have then gone on in turn to finance, support, give succor and create conditions for the rise of ISIS. Somebody has to start saying this stuff, Taoiseach, because the consequences have been so devastating. And lastly, Taoiseach, you mentioned your attendance at the UN meeting in New York. Can I ask you, I've heard an unconfirmed report, and I'd just like a straight and direct answer, did you meet or have in any engagement with General al-Sisi, the president and dictator, there's no other word to use for this man, of Egypt? Did you have any engagement, or did any of your officials or any representatives of the Irish state or political system meet General al-Sisi, the man who is engaging in mass executions, mass trials of his own citizens, including Ibrahim Halawa? And if you did you raise the case of Ibrahim Halawa, whose trial has been deferred yet again, 2 years, incarcerated in prison?
That's a separate issue to what you're asking here.
But it relates to what the Taoiseach mentioned about his attendance at the meeting in New York. So I'm asking, did you meet General al-Sisi in New York, or did any of your officials or anybody have any contact or engagement with him? And if they did, was the issue of Ibrahim Halawa raised?
Taoiseach.
Thanks. Thank you, Deputy Lord Barrett. I regard the comments made by candidate Trump as being absolutely outrageous. And I condemn them unreservedly in the context of immigrant people. We have 70 million people ourselves worldwide who claim Irish ancestry. Many of those were deported. Many of those left because of economic circumstances, many left because of colonization and the consequences of the Great Hunger. And it's something that's very deep in the Irish. I commend again our naval personnel who have taken from the waters of the Mediterranean over 7,000 people, men, women and children. I think in life and in politics, Deputy Boyd Barrett, sometimes you have to meet people with whom you disagree. Sometimes you meet people with whom you have very wide differences of opinion. Kennedy met Khrushchev, Reagan met Gorbachev, the Pope meets Castro, or whatever. I won't. No. The fact that Minister Noonan met a visitor to our country down in Shannon doesn't preclude Minister Noonan from having very strongly differing opinions about comments made by Mr. Trump in respect of immigrant people. This matter of Syria, Deputy Boyd Barrett, has been discussed at some considerable length at European Council meetings also, where the bigger countries in Europe have made and taken action in respect of the opposition in Syria to the Assad regime. We've discussed this before here, and everybody is of the view that the Assad regime should go. The latest intervention between Secretary of State Kerry and Mr. Leprov from Russia on how ISIS are to be dealt with in Syria obviously is a case in point, but the hundreds of thousands of people who are displaced and who are living in camps both in Jordan and in South Lebanon and are trekking across into Turkey and from there into Europe speaks for itself about this absolutely devastating issue. So we spoke of the European position here and the need for action to be taken to end this war. We have another situation in Libya where there's no government either, and where now we have open season from the Horn of Africa moving through to Europe. Finally, I might say to you, you mentioned, yes, I did meet with the President of Egypt and had a meeting with him for 30, 40 minutes with Minister Sherlock, with officials. Spoke to the President about Ibrahim Halawa and made it very, very clear and without any equivocation of our desire that this young man should be able to return home to Ireland here. Minister Flanagan has had detailed discussions on this in the last week. I also made it clear, however, that we cannot change the judicial court system in any other country. And I discussed very clearly with the President the question of the eligibility, once the system would be through, of a presidential pardon for Ibrahim Halawa. I left the President in no doubt of what our request there is, and that a presidential pardon should be considered and should be granted so that this young man could come home.
Thank you.
Obviously, in speaking to the President, I wasn't aware at the time that the trial would again be postponed because of the illness of two of those who were on trial. But I can confirm to you, I did meet with them, formally with the officials, minutes are taken, and along with Minister Sherlock, and we also discussed the quality of the developmental programmes that Ireland does in sub-Saharan Africa, and he expressed himself interested in learning more about those in view of the number of immigrant people and refugees taken into Egypt over the last period.
Thank you.
But I can send you a report of the meeting, which is very clear, Deputy Boyd Barron.